How many of you think you know autonomous car now?
Could you define now?
Well, I mean, it's like when you take an exam, right? Professor come give you a lecture, and then they ask you at the end of the lecture, like how much you learn from that lecture.
And they roughly know me.
Has any of you get a ride in an autonomous car before?
No.
Okay, so actually before I started working on autonomous car, I had no idea what it is, right? So I think at this point you're in a much better position than I was back then. So let's switch the topic a bit, and I will present my personal journey of how I get involved in this kind of research and development and this technology. So before I inform about our company, Newtonomy is, we are still a startup, trying to tackle the most difficult challenge in self-driving cars, and it's the urban driving. Right? Why is it challenging? Right? If you just drive on a highway, it's usually very simple, right? You just keep staying in your lane, following the front car, but when you drive in urban settings, there are people, there are jaywalking people, there are many cars that violate the rules, right? And you need to figure out how to handle these situations. So for our company, we focus on the software part. We consider many pieces for the autonomous car. Starting from perception means how do you try to get understanding of what the current world is. Where are the other cars? Where are the other people? Where is us? Where is our car in this world? Right? And then from what you see, now you need to decide what to do. Right? And that's what we call the planning and control. So it involves a lot of decision making, just like when you drive. Right? There's a car stop in front of you. Are you overtaking or you want to stay behind? Right? Once you make a decision, then you have to actually plan the motion, right? And then you need to actually actuate the car to follow that motion that you plan, right? And then there are many other things in the background as well, like communication, fleet management, simulation, and so on. But the part I focus on personally is this second piece, which is the planning and also the control. That's where my expertise is. Currently we are testing our software at many places, including the US, UK, and here in Singapore. And we try it on many types of car, electric cars. Actually in Singapore, all the cars we have are electric. In the US, we try our software on a hybrid car. And in the UK, it's also the IC platform. And we have no problem driving on the right-hand side, like in the US, or left-hand side, like in Singapore. So that's about Newtonomy. Let me try to explain a bit how I get involved in this autonomous car business and this journey. Actually, it started about 10 years ago. Yeah, it's from 2006. That's when the DARPA announced the DARPA Urban Challenge. Has anyone heard about this competition before? Oh, interesting. So the DARPA Urban Challenge is a race of autonomous vehicle. All the vehicles are completely autonomous. They give you a map of the environment, of the place you have your car has to drive, I think 3 days ahead of the race. Then 5 minutes before the race, they give you a thumb drive, let's say where your car has to get to. They give you the thumb drive, then they time it 5 minutes. You have, in this 5 minutes, you can do whatever with the car, and then everybody has to get out of the car. There cannot be any communication at all with the car. The car cannot even signal what it's thinking, what it's trying to do. So the team has no idea what the car is doing. We only get that 5 minutes to set up everything, make sure that everything is working. We get out, the only communication we have with the car is the remote e-stop. So DARPA, this is with the DARPA staff. They have the remote e-stop that could stop the car when it's very dangerous. But usually before they stop, they will ask us if like this is normal, should we let it go? And in that situation, we need to try to guess what the car is thinking, why it's doing that, is it safe to continue? Because if you run into an accident, then you might be pretty much done with the competition. So that's 2006. Actually, at that point, I was around the end of my first year as a grad student. I was pretty much having nothing much to do, so I was like, okay, I don't know what autonomous car is, but it sounds interesting. So I decided to, actually back then, it went like this. So there was an announcement about this competition. Then my advisor back then at Caltech said, we want to involve in this competition. Now we need to organize some meetings, gathering students and people around. And he asked for some volunteer to, because we need to split up into groups and each group needs some kind of coordinators. Right? So I was like, it's just like 1 hour meeting, I'll just do it. So I did it 1 hour. And then it became 1 hour a week. And by the time I know, it's like 20 plus hours a day. So that's how it goes until 2007 is the actual race. So this is the car that we developed back at Caltech. It's quite big, it's quite ugly. but back then we think that this is quite cool. We have a bunch of sensors. This bumper is actually more expensive than the car itself because it has many, many sensors. So that's 2007. We went to the race. And then after the race, I did still, then I was back to research as a PhD student. I got a lot of motivation from what we found at the race. Then my research was more on the VNV stuff, verification and validation. Then in 2010, Emilio started the Future Urban Mobility, the SMART. That he mentioned, and then I joined because it's so interesting. I also like Singapore because it's so close to home. My home is in Thailand, so it's very close. And then around 2012, I need to get back home, work in Thailand. And then around 2014, that's when Nutonomy launched. And I think at that point, I get to talk to Emilio again that we started this company, and I was also interested in joining, so I worked part-time back then until I think around October of 2015. Actually, September, we bought the vehicle, our first vehicle in Singapore, and then in October, I joined. Then in November 2015, we have the first public demo of our software that happened in the US. And then just earlier this year, we finished converting our cars into autonomous car. And then we went to FDA safety test. This is the test required for us to be able to drive around public road. So this is like when you drive as a human, you need to go through some kind of driver license test as well. Right? So they have similar tests for autonomous car. After March, then April, we get approval. So essentially, we pass the test in March, and in April, we get formal approval that we can drive on a public road in whatnot. And then in May, we gave live demos to many journalists in whatnot. This is in a very uncontrolled environment because a bunch of cars can drive around as well. There are a lot of parked cars. And since then, we have been giving many, many demos. And each time we go out to a demo, we find many interesting situations because the environment changes every day, right? Sometimes it rains, sometimes the sun is very bright, sometimes the traffic is very heavy, sometimes there are a lot of pedestrians jaywalking and so on. So the more we test, the more we learn about, you know, these are situations we need to be able to handle. You can see the progress of the car, right? From starting from this huge ugly car into this kind of group, which is much nicer, and now this car, which is much cleaner and nicer. So that's like the progress we are making. Let me first show you, this is my first experience with autonomous car. This is the DARPA Urban Challenge. The race was actually at the military base that is essentially abandoned. So there are still like road with all the signs, landmarking and everything. As I said, this is completely autonomous. Then they also create interesting situations for us with other human-driven vehicles. For example, in this test run, there are like 10 to 12 human-driven cars driving around the loop, and then we have to be able to merge into the traffic. There's also a situation where we need to handle traffic, the stop sign. There's also this big loop we need to go around, and there are many interesting scenarios here. We start from here, then we need to go through some narrow start chute, and for us, because we have a huge car, we struggle a lot with this, trying to go through. Then there's also this narrow gate. Once you go down, you also find the narrow winding roads. There's a parking lot here, which is almost full, and we have to go into one spot. Then also this unstructured region with an opening in a fence that we have to be able to navigate. There's also a road with cars on each side that we have to be able to avoid. All this has to be completely autonomous. Yeah, you can see how dense the traffic can be in one of these tests. So this is the video taken from a camera attached to our car. At this time, there's absolutely nobody inside the car at all. So the car has to make the decision completely by itself. And in certain situations, DAPA will ask us, do we want to emergency stop the car or not? Right? So you can see that the road is also very narrow compared to our size. But in this case, the road is quite empty. But it's very narrow. Most of the scenarios are quite static. There are parked cars that we have to avoid and so on. I think this is where the emergency stopped us, because they thought we are heading into this fence. And then they asked us, like, do we want the car to continue? And back then we said, okay, we think it should be able to continue. And then they let it go. And then it's actually able to continue. Yeah, so back then it's quite interesting and challenging. We have a team of about 50 people at a time. So we work quite closely together, spend a lot of time together as well. Let's see if there's something interesting. Actually, the video is quite long because this road is very long. Let me show you another interesting one, which is the merging one, where that one, our car did very well. For our car, with dealing with static environment is very well. But when we need to merge into traffic with the narrow road, we didn't do it quite well. In this case, we actually reversed in the middle of the intersection. This is because of many logics that we implemented. Essentially, we don't want our car to get stuck at all. But then, because you can see how narrow this road is, and there's this K-rail on the right. So a lot of time we try to get away from the K-rail. But then on the left side, there's also many cars. And so we didn't do quite well in this case. And so from this, we actually learned a lot. And it became the motivation of most of my work after that. So that's 2007, right? And then in 2010, we started the Future Urban Mobility and was also part of it. So actually at SMART, I was working on many different things, but all involving traffic system. So autonomous car is one project I was involved in. I also looked at traffic control. So that's more like the bigger picture of how you control the overall traffic. So over there, we also developed, these are the golf carts. We convert them into autonomous car, and also run the public trials at the Chinese Garden, as Emilio mentioned. So here we ran it for 6 days, driven about 360 kilometers total, with 500 visitors, 200 plus trips, and many surveys. And I think this is some of the video from there.
And have you heard about this or had the chance to go?
That's what our kids are writing. Yeah, the nice thing about this is, I mean, there are pedestrians walking around, but there are no fast-moving car around us. So, and our car is still driving very slowly. So that's the part that make it a bit more simpler than like driving around whatnot. Yeah, so most of them are quite happy with this. Have a very good experience.
Yeah, you cannot hear the audio here, but this lady is saying, I was sitting in the car and the car was staying away from the tree. Yes, well, that's kind of the point.
Yeah, for safety reasons we also have.
When was somebody crossing the, you know, it would stop, right?
Yeah.
It was
kind of
interesting. And yeah. This lady is actually saying that, you know, this would be very useful for her, you know, she doesn't want to walk too far in the park, so having such a service available in the park would be very beneficial, especially for the senior citizens.
Don't be
so
certain for walking long distances to come to Gada as well.
Oh, no. Sorry. Just figure out how to turn this on. Okay, so that is smart. So finally, most of the team from SMART move over to the company once we know that the technology is a bit more mature. Not that mature, but it's still to the point that we can trial in a more larger scale. So this is the part of the public demo we gave around whatnot. Not sure if it's the same video as me, but that day we gave so many demos. I think we do like 20 plus runs. And so this is one of the videos from there. You can see that, you know, this is parked car that we have to avoid, right? With some pedestrian walking around, this car behind us. Yeah, it's quite very interesting driving around there. Every single day we learn something new by just driving around. There was one day, there was a car going this direction, which is completely wrong. Yeah, so we saw pedestrian, we stopped for them. Yeah, and in this video you can see that the car is actually driving autonomously. We are not manually taking over at all. When we turn here, then there's a parked truck. Actually, when we gave this demo, it was quite, I mean, we are still developing the technology. We were running the latest ever code that we are actually, in the beginning, we were debating whether, you know, we should run like the version we know it was running, but it's less exciting, or we should turn on all these new features about avoidance and everything. And then we said, okay, let's just make it a bit more interesting and just, you know, run the latest software. And turns out that it was doing quite nice. I mean, with all the avoidance, following. Yeah, but some of the complaint we get is that the ride is a bit jerky. So with that comment, then we try to improve the performance of the car, making the ride smoother. Yeah, so that's one small loop. Actually, in this small loop, we usually find many interesting behaviors. Yeah, so this happened around May. And then we also, as we keep testing, as I said, we'll find more and more interesting situation. Go to another. This is another term we run, different days. These days, there's a series of car parking, and we need to be able to avoid. So some days the area is just crazy. There's so many cars, many illegal parkings, many